Hello friends, this is me, Anil Polchani. This video is regarding the interview point of view, which we'll be covering on the DB2 topic. So coming videos, guys, coming all my videos will be regarding your interview questions and the answers that you are supposed to give in the interview panel. Okay. See, every day, guys, alternate day or let's say weekly, at least 2 or 3 days, I will be taking interviews. And I find that no one has a basic understanding of answering the regular questions at least. Okay. So we're going to discuss those questions which I'll be asking in an interview with a basic approach. Okay. Not a scenario based questions, guys. This is a basic questions that everybody should know mandatorily. So these will be some from a decision factor that you have a basic knowledge. I can select you, I can train you a little bit in my work, and I can keep it in my project. So if you cannot answer these basic questions as well, then I will not able to select you, guys. Similarly, any other person also cannot select you directly. So these are the DB2 questions that we'll be covering. Okay, there are some topics we'll be covering in COBOL, some basic questions in JSL as well. Okay. So if you are going for an interview and your resume says that you are good in COBOL, JSL, DB2, then these are the questions and answers which you need to present in the interview. Okay. So I'll tell you some tricks. I'll tell you some answers. Try to prepare such way. Okay. Put your resume properly. Get job instantly. Okay. Get selected in the job, guys. You will not have hundreds of interview openings, guys. This is mainstream world. You'll be having a very good openings, but not huge openings. Okay. At the same time, along with you, there are few people who might have real experience, who are really good, or also competing for the same job. Now, the benefit you should be having is to clear the interview round more confidently. So for that purpose only, guys, this is regarding the interview purpose only. The concepts that we are covering will be a little bit confusion for you if you don't know anything, but if you are good in something of basics and you want to clear an interview round, our videos will be helping you a little bit, guys. Okay, so let's go to the first question that will be very common in any interview. That's about the pre-compilation, guys. Now, if you already attended an interview, you might already seen this question many times. If you have googled the point, what are the interview questions on DB2, this is also a familiar question, guys. Okay, so let's talk about this small topic. Let's understand how you should answer in interview and what kind of questions that might be expected. Okay, so we'll keep this video short so that you don't need to prolong long time for understanding it. Okay, so anytime they ask you about explain about pre-compilation, okay, explain about the pre-compilation. Now put your hands, okay, put your hand with all your fingers, okay. Each finger will tell one point, okay. Just put your hand yourself in your place, as you are not going for face-to-face interview, as you are in the home and you are using your phone or your online on a video call. Put your fingers in place. For each statement that you are writing here, close that finger and tell that answer. Okay. So first, what you need to tell here is, since we have both COBOL and DB2 code together, we cannot okay, use only COBOL compiler. We cannot use only COBOL compiler. That is first point. Second point, in here we use a process known as pre-compilation. In here, or in pre-compilation, in this process, point one, we use DSN HPC as the pre-compiler. The word what you should use is pre-compiler, which will be used to replace the exit SQL statements with COBOL code. That's what you have to tell. Don't tell anything here. Then the SQL query, okay, the SQL query which is written in the program, which is coded in the program is extracted and stored as output. Okay, create an output as DBR. Okay, database resource module. Nobody will ask you, don't tell this point. Okay, you just tell that SQL query will be extracted and will be creating a DBR. Also the precompiler will set a timestamp to the DBRM and modified COBOL code in the sense the code which doesn't contain any SQL. Why it's not containing any SQL? Because the precompiler has replaced the exit SQL statements. Okay, it has been replacing with the COBOL statement there. Now in here, once your precompiler is done, what you need to do here is after precompilation, you need to write this point in your hand. After precompilation, we get the DBRM for SQL and the modified COBOL code. This is the line that you need to tell after this point. Then, once we have the modified code, we use the COBOL compilation process. Okay, we use the COBOL compilation process and create the load module. Okay, so at the end of the story, the last point you need to tell here is once using the DBRM, okay, using the DBRM, we will do a bind process. We will do a bind process and create a package and link it to a plan for execution purpose. That's it. Don't do anything here. Okay, let me ask the questions on top of this. Your question was to elaborate precompilation process. Okay, somebody asked me, okay, Anil, can you please explain me precompilation process? I would say yes, since we are using a COBOL DB2 program, we will be need to go for precompilation process since COBOL compiler cannot understand the DB2 code. So in the precompiler, which is a program called DSN HPC, it will be doing an extract of the queries into a DBRM and all the exit SQL statements will be replaced with a COBOL suitable code. The modified COBOL code will be going for compilation process and will be getting a load. Now in the precompilation, we get one the DBRM and one we get the load. Now this DBRM will be used in bind process to create a package and the package will be linked to a plan for execution. That's it. Put these lines in your own way. You don't need to buy out what I told. Okay, you can jumble your answer, but you can have to put the words what I used. Once your answer is done, now expect the next questions on this topic. Okay, this topic is not done. You just cleared only one question there. Don't give everything that you already know. Wait, because immediately they will ask you on the question of package and plan. They will ask you this one. What is the difference between package and plan? We did not tell anything there. We just give an overview there. Okay, so we say package and plan concept here. Let them ask. If they're not asking, you don't go for worry. Okay, you are happy there, because this is the topic which is much confusion for all of us. Not for me, but for you. If they ask you what is a package and what is a plan, so you say a simple thing. Package contains the bound form of the DBRM. When I say bound form, guys, it is like an updated format of the query, which is in the DBRM. Bound in the sense updated. So you're going to tell that package contains bound form of DBRM. And in this step, this is important. In this step, we will provide the schema name, we will provide the owner, we will provide the isolation levels and other required details. Okay, don't give everything. What you are supposed to give is what you can answer. Okay, your answer will be your next question, guys. Most of your interviewers will pick up the question from your answer. Okay, so I want them to be coming into my plan only. Okay, I'm gonna start pre-compilation, but my answer will be highlighted with the package and plan as the last statement. When they ask me about package and plan, I would say package contains the bound form of DBRM. In here, in this step, we will provide the schema name, owner, isolation level. This would be a next expected question, guys. That's why we need this word to be highlighted in your answer. Okay, so isolation level and other required details while creating the package. Now, when they ask about plan, now plan is contains, okay, plan contains the connection, okay, the access with the DB2 system. Now, most of my interviews, a lot of people come and tell that plan contains the optimized access path, okay. Now, whether the interviewer know that word or not, but I know really what that word is. But it's not the way to answer that point, because the next question is what is optimized access path will come to you. So avoid that point as of now. Okay. When they ask you what is a plan, you say that plan contains connections and access with the DB2 system. And just continue. We use this in the execution. We use this in the execution of the program query. That's it. Plan contains the access or connection with the DB2 system. Package contains your query, guys. Package contains your query details. And query written in a package is not executable by itself. Okay. For your easiness, for your convenience, and for your own satisfaction, you can add that package is not executable, because it's a query, guys. Query cannot be executed by itself. It needs connection. That's why you can add a word for yourself. Plan is executable. That's it. Pre-compilation question they come, package and plan question they'll come to you. So if somebody asked me, Anil, can you just please explain me what is the difference between package and plan? So I would say that package contains the bound form of the DBRM query. In here, we'll be using bind parameters to provide the schema name. We'll provide the owner of access. We'll provide the isolation levels for locking and other details. Now, but the package, once it is created, is not executable by itself. In DB2 systems, we need plan for execution. So we will create a plan which we connect with the packages, and plan contains the connection to the DB2 system. So for execution, we need a plan which itself will contain the package and execute it. So package is not executable, plan is executable. Your answer should be slow. Your answer should be in a flow that you are answering properly, but not by hearted answer. Now, on this topic, guys, on this topic, there will be another question. Okay, another common question here. Like, what if I change the program? Okay, there is an existing program. There is an existing COBOL DB2 program. I made a change. Now, how do you compile? Okay. What steps you do for compilation? Now here, guys, for any change, whether it is a query change or whether it is just a code of COBOL change, we always do pre-compilation and then again the bind, okay, the bind process. But you need to tell that you're going to do bind process only to update the package. Okay, this is what the interviewer is expecting. You do the bind process, okay? You do the bind process, but only for package, not for plan, guys. Okay, not for plan here. Only for a package. You need to update only the package, and the package is already connected to the plan. In the first time only, when your program is written for the first time, when it is a new program, at the setup on the first time only, your packages are connected to a plan. So you don't need to do bind of a plan again. No need to do that. Only just do the pre-compilation of your program. You get the updated load. You got the updated DBRM. Then do the bind package and create the package for it. That's it. It is ready for execution, guys. Fourth question on the same topic. Sometimes you may come across that I have a program A and there is a sub-program B. In this, I have the DB2. What steps you take for compilation? First steps for compilation. Guys, don't get confused here. Don't get confused. Whether it is a program A or program B, okay? While compilation, you have to do separately only, okay? You need to do it separately only. If it is program A, which is only COBOL code, you do only compilation process. You get the load, that is enough. But if it is a program B, which is a COBOL DB2 program, COBOL DB2 program, then obviously you have to do pre-compilation. You cannot do compilation here, you know that pre-compilation is required and you need the compilation and also you need the bind process all to be done. Don't think it is a sub-program, don't think it is a main program. Any program you are compiling, you will be compiling it separately first. So while you are compiling your sub-program, your pre-compilation, compilation, bind has to be done and you get both the load for the program and plan for the code. So individually compilation to be answered. Do not answer together. Don't get confused with the question. Question doesn't have anything. This is main program, this is sub-program. No, that is not the point related for compilation. Unless if they ask you on a static call and dynamic call, that is a COBOL question, guys. Okay, when the subprogram concept is coming with static and dynamic point of view, then you need to answer it in that way of approach. But in here, it's not about static call, it's not about dynamic call. It is about your a program having COBOL, a program having a COBOL DB2. So how do you do it? So execution part will be interesting one. How do you execute? Always execution is done by IKJEF T01, guys. In that, you'll be running the program. Which program you'll be running, guys? The main program only. Every time you have to run main program only. But the plan will be the name what you created here. Okay. Suppose it is a plan of X. So use X here. Main program doesn't have a plan. That's fine. Not a problem. When system is executing the sub-program and when system comes against any query, that time the plan will be used. Main program, there are no queries, so plan will not be used. But sub-program has a query to run, a plan is required there. So you'll be having your main program and the plan what you have here. Okay, again, if you're not understanding this in a one time, repeat, guys. Okay, this is a video, you just go back one step and just reverse it. Okay, you have a program A as main, you have a program B as sub program. How do you compile and how do you execute? This is the answer. And if I want to go short, in short, okay, we are already completing 20 minutes here. I'm gonna add one more question for you about the count, guys. About the count, some people say that okay, I have three programs. How many? I have three programs, and each program has like three queries. Okay, three queries. Now the question is, how many DBRMs will be created, how many packages will be created, and how many plans are required? The count, okay, the count question, guys. Now I will not answer this question. I will answer you the basic way, because in the interview they will not ask you this question. They will ask you their own way of count. They may say one program, two program, three queries, five queries. So the question doesn't matter, guys. The answer is really matters. For each program, okay, for each program, if it is containing one query or 10 queries or 100 queries, whatever the query count is. For each program, when you do the pre-compilation, for your pre-compilation, you get one DBRM. Okay, so one program, one DBRM. Then, once you get the DBRM, for one DBRM, for each DBRM, you get one package, guys. You get one package. Now, This one package or many packages can be linked or attached to one plan. Okay, it's up to your application, guys. Okay, your application, let's say your project application is A. In that, sometimes what happens, you'll have only one plan contains all project or your all application packages. That means if you have 100 programs, 100 packages, all will be linked with only one plan. That is enough. Now some applications, let's say you are in application B, in that you may have one plan for each packages. Now this is not a regular practice one. Okay, regular practice one, this will contain a little bit confusion always in the project. Now in your answer, you tell that you have only one plan for all the packages. Okay, if they ask you how your application is using in that format, yes, you give an answer, yes, in my application all the programs they are using only one single plan. So if you know this answer, you can frame any question and you can give any answer there, guys. Okay, so this is again regarding a DB2 point only. I will add some more videos. Okay, I'm very busy with all my classes, as because of you've been following with me in my YouTube channel, you've been sharing the videos to a lot of your friends, and a lot of others are coming for training directly. So I'm been finding myself very hard with the time, but I made up a plan of myself. At least I'm gonna create a video for a week, get you clear your interviews first. Okay, once you are clearing with your interview, then come and join the training for your project purpose. Okay, for a project purpose, these videos are not enough, guys. Your YouTube channel videos are only for the people who are already good in mainframe for just refreshing purpose. But if you are a fresher, you are going for interview, yes, the videos which I'm sharing will be helpful for interview level, but for a project level, they are not good, guys. You need a lot of good practice. You need some good practice programs, good logical approach as well. So those things we will discuss in the classes. But this one, okay, are simple questions, and the topic what we are discussing is only pre-compilation process. For your last step, okay, for your last step, I just need to add it quickly. The pre-compiler, this is what we have for DSN HPC. Then your compiler, the COBOL compiler, you have IGY CRCTL. Then the link editor, nobody will ask you about this one, just for your knowledge, HEWL. And the bind process for both package and plan, okay, both will be done by a utility called IKJEFT01. And the fifth one is for execution. Okay, for execution also you'll be using same utility, IKJEFT01. Okay, this is the utility which is a very best friend for DB2. So you want to talk to DB2 programmatically, then this utility is the one which will be acting as a mediator. Okay, so remember the program numbers as well, remember the program names as well, maybe may not be useful. Go through the points. If you have a doubt or a question that you want me to ask to me, yep, send it in a comment, guys. We'll see that we'll have more interview recordings videos onto your channel. Okay, see you then.